Shall we rise for the entrance of the bride? Make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. There's an aspect of love that many people think about, but it's crucial in marriage. There's a famous Beatles song that says, "All you need is love." But if you really lived out this marriage, if you're married, you know that's sometimes not enough. You can love all you want, but if the recipient of the love doesn't receive it as love, then it's just a waste of time. Love, therefore, has to be transmitted with the perspective of the recipient of that love. Of course, if things were that easy, the problem is men and women understand love completely different. And because of that, we get into all kinds of misunderstanding. So I want to kind of address this to a couple right now. Lee, for women to understand love, it is important that you show your love in the context of security. God just made women this way. Jung-un needs to feel secure in this marriage, that she doesn't have to prove herself, that she is fully accepted, loved, and cherished, and pursued even after this wedding is over. Basically, she has to know and feel that she is the center of your universe. Having said all that, Jung-un also needs to know the love that men understand. The way men understand love is always in the context of respect. Men were just made this way. The Bible says, wives, submit to your husband, not because they have a higher IQ, not because they're stronger, not because they know everything, and not because they're more spiritual or better than you, but because the way God made them. And that's why it is important that women show that respect and submission. And as a result, the man will feel loved and supported. I've seen highly skilled men accomplish great things in life, in this world, only to come home to a wife that makes them feel small, belittles them. And the careless comments and poor treatments of their husbands ultimately destroys marriages. And there's a wise saying, if you break a man's ego, you're stuck with it. And many wives here know what I'm talking about. There's nothing uglier than a man with a shattered ego. It is a wise woman that shows love to her husband by showing respect. And so lastly, this thing that is called a marriage is a covenant. We're making a promise, a covenant with God. A covenant is not a contract. A covenant, even if one side fails to produce or fails to meet expectation, it does not free you or absolve you from this promise you're making before God. As a verse was read, it is sacrificial and sometimes a lonely road. And sometimes you have to carry this burden on your own. This passage is about Jesus, husband, dying for the wife. That's what this is. It's sacrificial love. And so that's what we're doing today. That's why what we're doing today is so important. And so, are you ready?
I am.
Okay, here we go. If you could hold each other's hand, look into each other's eyes, and please respond with "I do." Do you, Lee, take Jung-un to be your wife, to have and to hold, for better or for worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health? Do you promise to love and to cherish her until you are separated by death?
I do.
Do you, Jung-un, take Lee to be your husband, to have and to hold, for better or for worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, do you promise to love and to cherish him until you're separated by death. Now the bride and the groom will exchange their rings as a symbol of their vows, and they've actually have their own vows that they will like to share.
Cherish you, respect you as my man, husband, through all the changes of our life. I will share and support your hopes, dreams, and goals. I vow to be there for you.
I take you to be my partner for life. I promise above all else to live in truth with you and to communicate fully and fearlessly, to give you my hand and my heart as a sanctuary of warmth and peace, and pledge my love, dedication, faith, and honor as I join my life with yours. With you, I've truly found home.
Do you guys have a ring?
We do have a ring.
Okay. Okay, why don't we start with
you?
Yeah, I'll hold this for you. You put it on her, yeah? Doesn't fit. Okay, there we go. Thank God. Okay, here we go. Now that Lee and Jung-un have given themselves to each other by solemn vow before us and before God as a witness, they've shown their affection to one another by joining hands. I pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Therefore, what God has joined together, let man not separate. Amen. Now you may kiss the bride.
Yeah.
Now the couple will pour the sand into in the center. There's two sand bottles that you see. Each grain of sand, each container or sand symbolizes their lives up to now. The blue one represents Lee. The white one represents Jung-un. And each grain of sand that's in there represents moments of time and memories that they have lived individually thus far. And each grain of sand is a reminder that their lives did not just happen out of a vacuum, but it was initiated by a loving God. Each grain of sand is a love and devotion that was poured out by loved ones that are in this place, moms, dads, brothers, sisters, and friends. The bowl represents this marriage covenant. In Genesis, it says that for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh. And Lee and Jung-un will pour their sand into this marriage, this bowl, and they are proclaiming that they will do the same for one another. They're pouring into each other's lives. So let's just observe that. That's a lot of sand. It just means there's a lot of love in this room, right? We as Christ followers believe that marriage is not only a union of two individuals, but of two families. In a way, you know, the Bible teaches that the man will leave his mother and father to find his wife. And therefore, it is important for me to remind you that there's an element of goodbye in a marriage as well. And so thank you to the families that have raised up your children thus far. You've done a great job. Now they have become adults, and they will forge their own path. So thank you, thank you. If I may ask you to rise at this time for benediction, and we'll wrap up this ceremony. Let us pray. Father, we want to thank you, God, for your providence over Lee and Jalen thus far, God, and how you have raised them to be where they are today. Father, we recognize that this is not an accident or coincidence that they've met, but God, that from the beginning of time, you've arranged for this. And Father, we want to bless this couple as they take a new chapter in their lives. And God, we come together as a family, as a community, and Father, we want to celebrate together what you have done, the good works that you have done. So we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And now the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of the Father and the fellowship and communion of the Holy Spirit be upon you from this day forward forever. Amen. Amen. So if you may turn toward there. Now I'd like to introduce to you Mr. Lee and Mrs. Jung-un Reynolds.